Sir Michael Tippett designed The Rose Lake to be his last piece. It was premiered by the LSO under Sir Colin Davis in 1995 to mark Tippett's 90th birthday. Tippett called it a song without words for orchestra, and it marks a return to his lyrical style. The piece depicts dawn to dusk at a saltwater lake in Senegal that changes colour from pale green to pink as the sun rises higher. After a mysterious dawn introduction, Tippett writes in the score, "The lake begins to sing." It sounds almost like the beginning of Wagner's Ring Cycle, horns, clarinets, and strings. After the song has ended, the woodwind have a contrasting, spiky rhythm. And later, Tippett asks the rototoms to sound jaunty. Then we have a variation on the song. The lake song is echoed from the sky. One of the most exciting bits in the next interlude is given to the trombones, their right arms, absolutely frantic. Another variation, the lake is in full song. Two orchestral lines at once, with the smooth string one predominant. In the whole piece is given to the tuba, transforming that string sound that we've just heard. There's a sort of fugue for oboes first and then on bassoons. Another variation as the sun begins to set, the lake song leaves the sky, a reflection of the original shape. And finally, the lake sings itself to sleep. Spiky chords to end, and by the last one, for trumpets and trombones, Tippett writes, "Plop," as some little creature drops into the safety of the dark lake.